this is Lorabella from www.manifestingmydestiny.com and www.manifestingyourtruelove.com. And today we will be talking to a very powerful lady. She's all about spirituality. From what I've been chit-chatting with her a while ago, she is all about spirituality and I'm so impressed. So let's all welcome Miss Yeshi Shadron. Hello, Yeshi.
Hi, how are you today?
Good, good. So, Yeshi, can you tell me a little bit about yourself and what do you do?
Sure. It's interesting, I've recently been dubbed by a peer of mine as the Transformational Breakthrough Goddess. I am a healer and I am a life coach. And what I do is I assist people, particularly women, in claiming their personal power. You know, as you mentioned, I rely heavily on spirituality for myself, and I can help my clients, you know, gain a broader perspective of spirituality or a more in-depth perspective and practice of spirituality in their lives so that they can really have a rich, juicy experience while we're here on Earth.
That's awesome. So the people who are following me are those people who are actually looking for love, and I have come across your article on diet, and of course there are a lot of people who have lost interest in looking for someone because, like, you know, they're wondering how can they find someone if they have not so good physical health. So maybe you can share like quick tips on how can people work on this, you know, something which is easy, because, like, you know, people have probably tried everything and then they're getting frustrated and everything.
Yeah, I'm glad that you asked me that. I had some problems in the past myself with weight and, did some yo-yo dieting and this kind of thing. And I finally got to a place where in the last year I lost 32 pounds. And this is the longest that I've sustained weight loss. And I'm still dropping weight, which is great. I never felt hungry, never felt, you know, deprived or anything like that. And I would say one of my biggest tips is to find a whole natural food that you really enjoy and explore different ways of preparing it. You know, try it raw, try it lightly cooked, try it in a salad, or try it mixed into another dish. And so that brings me to my second tip, which is add things in. At first about taking things out of your diet, really try adding healthier things into your diet first. Because I think one of the biggest problems that we have with dieting is that we think it's, I can't have this and I can't have that. I have to cut back this and that. Yes, those things do help. But we really want your body and your spirit to be in a place of feeling nurtured and nourished. And if you begin adding in healthy things first, then that can help take away that feeling of not having enough or not being enough, you know, which is often an underlying cause of our eating problems, right?
Mm-hmm. So I also have this confusion because, I'm wondering, do you really have to cleanse yourself first before you can go on a diet?
Yeah, that's a good question. A lot of people feel like a cleanse is absolutely necessary. What I want to say about that is, for me, a cleanse is really helpful. It's kind of like when you have your living room full of clutter. So when you do a cleanse for your body, it's like removing the clutter so that you can really see what's there, so that you can really see what the state of your health actually is. And I believe that if we don't start with where we are, we end up someplace that we don't want to be, or we end up someplace that's great, but then we ricochet back to where we don't want to be, you know? So I think it's a good way to start with where you are, to find out where you are right now with your health and with your body, and even with your emotional health and your mental health, you know? So a cleanse is not absolutely necessary, but I do feel like it helps us a great deal. And I want to speak to that a little bit more. A cleanse doesn't necessarily have to be, oh my gosh, I'm only going to drink lemon water for 7 days straight. You know, that's one way that a cleanse can look. But a cleanse can also look like having 3 or 4 meals a day, plus a snack or two, and having a really nutritious, healthful, you know, experience with your food. These can be very rich and fulfilling foods. And a cleanse just means that you remove what your body views as toxic, okay? So if you're just removing, for example, if you drink a lot, maybe you drink less, or maybe you don't drink for a defined period of time. And which makes me, you know, remember about another aspect about cleansing, that people feel like a cleanse is something that you get on it and you stay on it long term. I don't subscribe to that way of thinking. A cleanse is a temporary period of time that you take and you give yourself a break from too much food, too much of the wrong foods, you know, not enough of the right foods. So it's just a break time. It's not meant to be sustained over a long period of time. So to fully answer your question, I think a cleanse is definitely helpful, but no, I don't think that it's absolutely necessary to start a diet. You know, if you do a cleanse in the right way, it won't even feel like a cleanse, and you'll really enjoy it. And so you'll sustain that weight loss for long term when doing a cleanse in the right way.
Okay, so you're talking about, you know, physical condition, but the thing is that because you're, you know, more or less, I see you as a holistic person. So do you also, how do you incorporate your mental, you know, your mental preparation with that cleansing? Maybe you can share, because, like, you know, probably some people are giving up because of that, you know, scare, like, okay, I'm gonna be, you know, hungry.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, well, that's actually, they're closely tied together. Our mental body and our physical body are closely tied together. So I have two comments on that. One is that, exactly like you just spoke into, a lot of us feel like, oh, a cleanse or a diet means I can't have, or that I have to, you know, starve, or that I'm going to be eating celery and carrots for 3 weeks, you know. And it's not about taking away from your body what it needs. It's about giving your body more of what it needs. So when we take away from our body what it needs, then our brain starts to, our body starts to trigger chemicals in our brain that signify to the brain that we're in a state of depravity, you know, and so that we're in a state of hunger. And so with that state of hunger, then your brain starts behaving like you're in a state of depravity. Your brain starts behaving like, you know, oh, I'm desperate for companionship, or I'm desperate for more money, when that may or may not be true. You know, usually we're not desperate. You know, we're not desperate beings. We're not put on this earth to be desperate, right?
It's true. There's abundance over here.
There is lots of abundance, absolutely. And we are born inherently worthy of enjoying all of the companionship we could ever want. We're inherently worthy of enjoying all the abundance we could ever want, you know. And so when we do a cleanse in the proper way, then we're adding nutrition to our bodies. So we're not feeling deprived, and instead we are feeling more abundant. And that triggers happy chemicals in the body. It triggers a sense of fulfillment in the emotional body, so that we don't desperately look for a partner that doesn't match for us. We don't desperately look for a job that isn't the right fit for us. You know, when we feed our body nutritious foods and we feel abundant physically, then emotionally and mentally, we already start to feel abundant as well, right?
Yeah, that's so perfect. So maybe you can tell us what are your current projects and how can people find you?
Yeah, great. I'm actually heading off a cleanse right now, so I'm glad that you're asking about this. And the cleanse is called Spring Break Cleanse. You can get directly to the cleanse by going to tinyurl.com/ take you directly to the cleanse where you have all the details and things like that. So that's one of the big projects that I'm working on right now. This cleanse is the cleanse that I put myself on that headed off, oh my gosh, so much healing for me in my life. It started me on that 32-pound weight loss. It started to heal me out of an extremely trauma-filled and toxic marriage. And it started me onto my sacred path of self-love, which I've got to tell you, has been so amazing and fulfilling. It's incredible. I'm having better relationships with friends. I'm having better relationships with family. I have a soulmate, and we're called a really beautiful friendship right now. It's something that I've never allowed myself to have in relationships. I've always gone from meeting the person straight into a serious relationship that, oh, we're locked together and we're in this, you know? But what I really want for myself now, and what I really want to allow myself to have as a juicy, delicious treat, is to enjoy a beautiful, expansive friendship with this man, and then to enjoy a romantic relationship, and then to take it to a serious level. So I'm really happy about that, and this cleanse has started me on that path in my own life. What I'm working on with clients, aside from the cleanse, is I'm starting to give advice through my advice column called Dear Goddess, and it's been a wonderful treat to be able to help women from afar. It's fantastic. And I'm also working on inviting in a new wave of clients to work with one-on-one. So if someone wants to work with me and wants to learn how they can claim their personal power, I have some programs available for that as well.
Okay, can you tell me again the tiny URL? Because like I just want to make sure people got it.
Thank you. I absolutely will. It's tinyurl.com/ capital S with spring, capital B with break, and capital C with cleanse. So spring break cleanse.
That's awesome.
And the way that people can easily reach me is just to go to my website, and it's www.dancingwithhealingspirit.com. And it's all together, no spaces. Dancingwithhealingspirit.com.
All right, so there you go, folks. And then it was great talking to you, Aisha. Maybe you have some parting words before we go?
Yeah, I just want to tell everybody that love truly is abundant in this universe. It really is. And in order to experience the multitude of the facets of love and the magnitude of universal love, it really starts with self-love. It really does. So if you can find one or two ways to allow yourself to enjoy self-love, you'll find that your business relationships, your romantic relationships, your family relationships, and your friendships will start to open up for you in a little bit of a brighter way. So it really does start with self-love. So, I definitely encourage everyone to find a little bit of self-love, love for themselves, even right now, today.
That's awesome. Okay, thank you, folks. And then there we have it. Bye-bye, Aisha.
Bye, it was so great to join you. Thanks for having me.
All right, I'll speak to you soon. Take care, thank you.
Take care.
Okay, bye.
Bye.